For the last two periods, we have been discussing types of placenta, mammalian placenta. So in continuation of that, types of placenta according to the fate of uterine endometrium at parturition. According to the fate of endometrium at parturition. What is endometrium? We already discussed. So endometrium is nothing but the lining of the uterine cavity. Uterine cavity is lined by mucous membrane of the uterus. This is known as endometrium. So this is a layer which comes in contact with fetal placenta. Okay, so the fetus gets attached to this layer for getting its physiological benefits. So what is parturition? So parturition is nothing but a process by which the completely developed fetus expelled out of the uterus. This is known as birth or parturition of the young one. So at the time of parturation, you know how the endometrium behaves. According to that, there are three different types of placenta. Non-deciduate type, deciduate type, and contradeciduate type. Okay. First, let us discuss non-deciduous placenta or semi-placenta. Non-deciduous means here the fetal placenta comes in contact with maternal placenta. Maternal placenta is nothing but the endometrium. Endometrium has crypts or the pits. In these pits, the epithelium of the chorionic villi fit, they enter, they fix like this. So at the time of parturition, they just separate. Fetal placenta gets separated from maternal placenta without harming the endometrium, without rupturing or tearing the tissues of the endometrium. They just separate without causing any damage, any wound to the endometrium. Because of this, during the time of birth, there would be no bleeding. Just the fetal placenta gets separated from the maternal placenta without causing any damage to the endometrium. So such type of placenta is called non-deciduate type of placenta. Okay, or it's also called as simple placenta. Simple placenta is found in all marsupials. Then odd-toed ungulates such as horse, ass, zebra, tapir. So these are ungulates, mammals. They are odd-toed ungulates. There we can find this type of placenta, non-deciduous type of placenta or simple placenta. Clear? So decidual means damaged endometrium. If the endometrium gets damaged, ruptured during the time of birth of the young one, that type of endometrium is referred as deciduate type. Okay, so in deciduous placenta or placenta vera, deciduate type of placenta or placenta vera. So here what happens, you know, at parturation, while the fetal placenta is being separated, It not only gets separated on its own, it is also removing some tissues of the endometrium or maternal placenta. Thus, it creates or it causes, you know, damage to the endometrium, Because of this damage, bleeding occurs. Bleeding occurs at the time of parturition. So, such type of placenta is called deciduous type of placenta. Okay, many mammals have this type of placenta. Human beings. So, we have, our women have this type of placenta, deciduous type of placenta. Okay. Next, contradeciduous type of placenta. Another type of placenta is there, known as contradeciduous type of placenta. Here, what happens is, parturition takes place, but fetal placenta is not separated. It is not ejected out of the maternal body. It remains inside the maternal body, that is inside the uterus, and gets cut into pieces. Later on, the pieces are absorbed in the maternal body itself. The fetal placenta is not ejected out during the time of parturition. Whereas in these two cases, the fetal placenta is ejected out at parturition. Whereas here, at parturation, fetal placenta is not ejected. It is remaining inside the maternal body. After some time, it gets reabsorbed into the female body. So such type of placenta is called as contradeciduous type of placenta. So example for this type of placenta are the rabbits and the talpa, mole. These are types of mammals. Okay, so there the placenta is not coming out of the body, maternal body. It would be reabsorbed within the female body. So thus there are three types of placenta based on fate of the endometrium at parturition. Okay, another type of classification of placenta are there based upon distribution of chorionic villi on the surface of the chorion or blastocyst. Okay. Okay. So another type of classification of placentae. Types of placentae according to the arrangement of villi on the blastocyst. According to the distribution of chorionic villi on blastocyst. Okay. So number one, diffuse placenta. Diffuse placenta. So look here, this is diffuse placenta. Blastocyst, surface of the blastocyst has distribution of villi. The villi are evenly distributed throughout the surface of the blastocyst. Such type of placenta is called the diffuse placenta. These are all chorionic villi. Chorion is the outermost extra embryonic membrane, comes in contact with endometrium of the mother, endometrium of uterus. Okay, so this has finger like projections called villi. These villi come in contact with membrane of the endometrium through which the exchange of physiological materials occur between maternal and fetal blood circulations. Okay, so diffuse type of placenta is found in pig and male ungulates. pregnant mare. Mare is female horse. Female horse.
Okay, cotyledonary placenta.
Cotyledonary placenta. Here, the coronary villi are distributed in batches. Distributed in patches all around the surface of blastocyst.
So here, can you see it? These are the patches of coronary villi. Coronary villi. So these are called cotyledons.
Cotyledons.
So such type of placenta is called cotyledonary placenta, found in cattle, sheep, and goat.
Even toad ungulates.
Cattle, sheep, goat,
they show this type of placenta, cotyledonary placenta.
Next, intermediate placenta.
So, intermediate placenta is also cotyledonary placenta, but in cotyledonary placenta,
so except patches of villi, the other surface of the blastocyst is smooth, it's not having villi, no villi present. Whereas here in case of intermediate placenta, patches of villi are there, and in between patches of villi, the coronary villi are also distributed here and there.
So it exhibits both type,
diffuse type as well as cotyledonary type. Therefore, this will be referred as
intermediate type. Intermediate. It has both the diffuse type as well as cotyledonary type. Such type of placenta is called
intermediate placenta, found in camel, giraffe.
Camel and giraffe.
Next, jewelry placenta.
Jewelry placenta.
So here,
jewelry placenta occurs in carnivores. Carnivores
such as dog, cat, lion, tiger.
The blastocyst of this animal, this type of animals,
has distribution of villi around the blastocyst in a belt-like
present around the blastocyst. Okay,
and here the two terminalites, no coronary villi, only at some region.
So this portion which is having coronary villi would be looking like belt-like around the blastocyst. So such type of placenta is called jewelry placenta. Jewelry placenta. It is restricted to particular zone of the blastocyst.
Then discoidal type.
Discoidal type.
So here the coronary villi are distributed
at particular region, and that region looks like disc, circular disc. Therefore, such type of placenta is called discoidal placenta.
Here, you see, it is disc like. Here only coronary villi are present. Not here.
Not here.
Okay?
Not here.
So only here. This one is. This one is. Distribution of coronary villi.
So discoidal coronary
villi. Yeah. Discoidal type of placenta is found in bat, bee, rodents, and rabbits.
Anteaters.
Rodents, squirrels, rat, they all have this type of placenta. Discoidal type of placenta.
The distribution of coronary villi on blastocyst is like a disc shape. Disc shape.
Then the metadiscoidal.
Metadiscoidal.
Metadiscoidal type of placenta is present in human beings and apes.
Human beings and apes. So metadiscoidal type of placenta is intermediate between discoidal and the diffuse type. So at the beginning, at first,
all surface of the inner surface has no limit here. Later, all these coordinate villi disappear, and only at certain region the villi are present, and that region looks like disc-like area has coronic villi. Therefore, such type of placenta is called metadiscoidal type. So, metadiscoidal type of placenta present in human beings and apes. So, these are different types of placentae classified on the basis of distribution of chorionic villi on blastocyst. So, with this, we have completed the types of placentae. Next, we shall discuss the physiological functions of placenta, uses of placenta. Okay? Thank you.